Welcome back, students. We'll discuss about the contiguous memory allocation. Here we have three methods: first fit, best fit, worst fit. First fit is used to allocate the memory for the processes which finds the first hole that is big enough to fit for that process. The second method is best fit. Here the process is allocated with the memory that has the smallest hole but that is big enough to hold that process. Here we must search the entire list unless ordered by the size. Worst fit method allocates the process with the largest hole and must also search the entire list for finding the largest hole first. Now to see the allocation of these three methods, we'll consider one problem. Here 5 memory partitions of size 100 KB, 500 KB, 200 KB, 300 KB, 600 KB in order are considered. The question is, how would the first fit, best fit and worst fit algorithm place the different processes, the four processes of size 212 kilobytes, 417 kilobytes, 112 kilobytes and 426 kilobytes in order? And we have to also find the most efficient use of memory using all the three methods. Now we'll consider the first allocation method, that is first fit method. The given 5 memory partitions are of size 100 KB, 500 KB, 200 KB, 300 KB, 600 KB. The incoming 4 processes are of size 212 KB, P2 of size 417 KB, P3 of size 112 KB, P4 of size 426 KB. Now we have to allocate these processes with these memory partitions. As we have discussed here, the first fit finds the first hole that is big enough. So P1 size is 212 and the first hole is of 100. Then next is of 500 kilobytes. So the first hole that is big enough to fit for P1 is 500 KB. So P1 is allocated with this memory partition. But the leftover memory is 500 minus 212 equal to 288. Then the next incoming process is P2 of size 417. So it will not fit into this partition. Then the second partition is already allocated. Then this is third partition is of size 200, which will not be fitted for process P2. Then 300 is also not fit for the process P2. So P2 is allocated to a block of size 600 KB. So here a small hole is created of size 600 minus 417 equal to 183 kilobytes. The next incoming process is P3 of size 112 kilobytes. So the first partition is 100 kilobytes. So requirement is more here. So it will go to the next free memory slot, that is 200 kilobytes. As it is big enough to hold that P3 process, it is allocated to this block with the leftover memory as 200 minus 112, which is equal to 88 kilobytes. Next incoming process is P4 of size 426. The partition P1 is not suitable for this. Then second and third partitions are already allocated with the process. Fourth partition is also of lesser size compared with the process memory requirement for P4. And fifth partition is already allocated. So P4 is not allocated with any memory. So P4 is unallocated with memory. Now we will find out the leftover memory which we call it as a fragmentation. First block is entirely free, 100 kilobytes plus. From the second block, we have one small hole of size 288 kilobytes. From third partition, we have one hole of 88 kilobytes. Fourth partition is completely free. Plus fifth partition, we have one small hole of 183 kilobytes. All together, it comes to 559 kilobytes. The memory requirement for P4 is 426. Even though this much memory is, total fragmentation memory is 959 kilobytes. The memory requirement for P4 fragmentation is 959 KB. The memory requirement for P4 is 426. But still, the first fit says P4 is not allocated with any memory partition. Now we'll go for the second method, best fit. The same memory blocks are considered here. The incoming processors are also same. The best bit says allocate the smallest hole that is just big enough to hold that particular process. So the incoming process is of 212 kilobytes, which is greater than first partition. So then it will go to the next partition of size 200. So here also it is not able to fit the process. Then it will go to the next partition of 300 kilobytes. So it will just fit into this block. So P1 is allocated with the partition of size 300 kilobytes with a leftover memory as 300 minus 212, which is equal to 88 kilobytes. The next incoming process is P2 of size 417. So first partition will not accommodate this P2 process. Then it will go to the second partition, which is big enough to hold the second process. So P2 is allocated with second partition of size 500 KB and a small hole of size 500 minus 417, which comes to 83 kilobytes, a hole is created. The next incoming process is P3 of size 112 kilobytes, which is greater than the first partition. Then second partition is already allocated with process P2. Then it will go to the third partition of size 200, which is just big enough to hold the process P3. So P3 is allocated with this block and creates one small hole of size 200 minus 112, which comes to 88 kilobytes. Next incoming process is P4, which is of size 426 kilobytes. So 100 is less than 426. So P4 will not be allocated with this partition. The next three are already allocated. So it will go to the last partition of size 600 kilobytes, just big enough to hold that process. So P4 is allocated with fifth partition of size 600 kilobytes and it creates one small hole of size 600 minus 426, which is of size 174 kilobytes. As all the processes are over, the algorithm stops the process allocation. Now, if we want to calculate the leftover memory here, the total leftover memory is, the first block is completely free, so 100 kilobytes, plus a small hole in second partition, 83 kilobytes, plus a small hole of 88 kilobytes in third partition, fourth partition again 88 kilobytes, then fifth partition has a hole of size 174 kilobytes, which will come to a total of 533 kilobytes, and all the four processors are allocated with memory here. Now we'll go for the third method, the worst bit, where the memory is allocated to the largest hole. We are considering the same processes here, P1, P2, P3, P4. So the first incoming process is P1 of size 212. So among this, it will search the first largest hole, that is 600 kilobytes, and P1 is allocated with this partition. The hole created is of size 600 minus 212, which is equal to 388 kilobytes. The next incoming process is P2 of size 417 kilobytes, which will find the next largest hole partition as 500, and P2 is allocated with this. The leftover memory in this partition is 500 minus 417, which is equal to 83 kilobytes. The next third process is of size 112 kilobytes. The third largest is partition of size 300 kilobytes. Here the P3 is allocated and it creates a hole of size 300 minus 112, which is equal to 188 kilobytes. Fourth process is of size 426 kilobytes. The next partition free is 200, which is not able to accommodate the process P4. So the worst fit algorithm says P4 is not allocated with any memory block. Now if you want to calculate a total leftover memory, which we call it as fragmentation, first block is completely free, 100 KB, plus a small hole in second partition. Third partition is 200. The fourth partition has a small hole of 188 kilobytes, plus the fifth partition has a hole of size 388 kilobytes. When we add all this together, we get a total fragmentation memory of size 959 kilobytes. The memory required for P4 process is 426. So even though this memory is available here as a complete block, but it says the required partition is not allocated. So when we compare the three methods, first fit, best fit, worst fit, so when we see the process allocation to the different partitions, first fit says P4 is not allocated with memory. Worst fit also says P4 is not allocated with memory, whereas best fit will allocate the memory to all the incoming four. So we can conclude that best fit method is the best method for contiguous memory allocation for given problem.